that bear fruit at the right time and whose leaves do not dry up. They succeed in everything they do, but evil men are not like this at all. They are like straw that the wind blows away. Sinners will be condemned by God and kept apart from God's own people. The righteous are guarded and protected by the Lord, but the evil are on the way to the doom. Psalms 2, God's chosen king. Why do the nations plan rebellion? Why do people make their useless plots? Their kings revolt. Their rulers plot together against the Lord and against the king he chose. Let us free ourselves from their rule, they say. Let us throw off their control. From his throne in heaven, the Lord laughs and mocks their feeble plans. Then he warns them in anger and terrifies them with his fury. On Zion, my sacred hill, he says, I have installed my king. I will announce, says the king, what the Lord has declared. He said to me, you are my son. Today I have become your father. Ask, and I will give you all the nations. The whole earth will be yours. You will break them with an iron rod. You will shatter them in pieces like a clay pot. Now, listen to this warning, you kings. Learn these lessons, you rulers of the world. Serve the Lord with fear, tremble and bow down to him, or else his anger will be quickly aroused and you will suddenly die. Happy are all who go to him for protection. Psalms 3, Morning Prayer for Help. I have so many enemies, Lord, so many who turn against me. They talk about me and say, God will not help him. But you, O Lord, are always my shield from danger. You give me victory and restore my courage. I call to the Lord for help, and from his sacred hill he answers me. I lie down and sleep, and all night long the Lord protects me. I am not afraid of the thousands of enemies who surround me on every side. Come, Lord, save me, my God. You punish all my enemies and leave them powerless to harm me. Victory comes from the Lord. May he bless his people. Psalms 4, Evening Prayer for Help. Answer me when I pray, O God, my defender. When I was in trouble, you helped me. Be kind to me now and hear my prayer. How long will you people insult me? How long will you love what is worthless and go after what is false? Remember that the Lord has chosen the righteous for his own, and he hears me when I call to him. Tremble with fear and stop sinning. Think deeply about this when you lie in silence on your beds. Offer the right sacrifices to the Lord and put your trust in him. There are many who pray, give us more blessings, O Lord. Look on us with kindness. But the joy that you have given me is more than they will ever have with all their corn and wine. When I lie down, I go to sleep in peace. You alone, O Lord, keep me perfectly safe.
Psalms 5, A Prayer for Protection. Listen to my words, O Lord, and hear my sighs. Listen to my cry for help, my God and King. I pray to you, O Lord. You hear my voice in the morning. At sunrise, I offer my prayer and wait for your answer. You are not a God who is pleased with wrongdoing. You allow no evil in your presence. You cannot stand the sight of proud men. You hate all wicked people. You destroy all liars and despise violent, deceitful men. But because of your great love, I can come into your house. I can worship in your holy temple and bow down to you in reverence. Lord, I have so many enemies. Lead me to do your will. Make your way plain for me to follow. What my enemies say can never be trusted. They only want to destroy. Their words are flattering and smooth, but full of deadly deceit. Condemn and punish them, O God. May their own plots cause their ruin. Drive them out of your presence because of their many sins and their rebellion against you. But all who find safety in you will rejoice. They can always sing for joy. Protect those who love you because of you. They are truly happy. You bless those who obey you, Lord. Your love protects them like a shield.
Psalm 6. A prayer for help in time of trouble. Lord, don't be angry and rebuke me. Don't punish me in your anger. I am worn out, O Lord. Have pity on me. Give me strength. I am completely exhausted, and my whole being is deeply troubled. How long, O Lord, will you wait to help me? Come and save me, Lord. In your mercy, rescue me from death. In the world of the dead, you are not remembered. No one can praise you there. I am worn out with grief. Every night my bed is damp from my weeping. My pillow is soaked with tears. I can hardly see. My eyes are so swollen from the weeping caused by my enemies. Keep away from me, you evil men. The Lord hears my weeping. He listens to my cry for help and will answer my prayer. My enemies will know the bitter shame of defeat. In sudden confusion, they will be driven away. Psalm 7. A prayer for justice. O Lord, my God, I come to you for protection. Rescue me and save me from all who pursue me, or else, like a lion, they will carry me off where no one can save me, and there they will tear me to pieces. O Lord, my God, if I have wronged anyone, if I have betrayed a friend, or without cause done violence to my enemy, if I have done any of these things, then let my enemies pursue me and catch me. Let them cut me down and kill me and leave me lifeless on the ground. Rise in your anger, O Lord. Stand up against the fury of my enemies. Rouse yourself and help me. Justice is what you demand. So bring together all the peoples round you and rule over them from above. You are the judge of all mankind. Judge in my favor, O Lord. You know that I am innocent. You are a righteous God and judge our thoughts and desires. Stop the wickedness of evil men and reward those who are good. God is my protector. He saves those who obey him. God is a righteous judge and always condemns the wicked. If they do not change their ways, God will sharpen his sword. He bends his bow and makes it ready. He takes up his deadly weapons and names his burning arrows. See how wicked people think up evil. They plan trouble and practice deception. But the traps they set for others, they themselves get caught. So they are punished by their own evil and are hurt by their own violence. I thank the Lord for his justice. I sing praises to the Lord, the Most High. Psalms 8. O Lord, our Lord, your greatness is seen in all the world. Your praise reaches up to the heavens. It is sung by children and babies. You are safe and secure from all your enemies. You stop anyone who opposes you. When I look at the sky which you have made, at the moon and the stars which you set in their places, what are human beings that you think of them? Mere mortals that you care for them. Yet you made them inferior only to yourself. You crowned them with glory and honor. You appointed them rulers over everything you made. You placed them over all creation, sheep and cattle, and the wild animals too, the birds and the fish and the creatures in the sea. O Lord, our Lord, your greatness is seen in all the world.
Psalms 9. Thanksgiving to God for His justice. I will praise you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all the wonderful things you have done. I will sing with joy because of you. I will sing praise to you, Almighty God. My enemies turn back when you appear. They fall down and die. You are fair and honest in your judgments, and you have judged in my favor. You have condemned the heathen and destroyed the wicked. They will be remembered no more. Our enemies are finished forever. You have destroyed their cities, and they are completely forgotten. But the Lord is King forever. He has set up His throne for judgment. He rules the world with righteousness. He judges the nations with justice. The Lord is a refuge for the oppressed, a place of safety in times of trouble. Those who know you, Lord, will trust you. You do not abandon anyone who comes to you. Sing praise to the Lord who rules in Zion. Tell every nation what He has done. God remembers those who suffer. He does not forget their cry. And He punishes those who wrong them. Be merciful to me, O Lord. See the sufferings my enemies cause me. Rescue me from death, O Lord, that I may stand before the people of Jerusalem and tell them all the things for which I praise you. I will rejoice because you saved me. The heathen have dug a pit and fallen in. They have been caught in their own trap. The Lord has revealed Himself by His righteous judgments, and the wicked are trapped by their own deeds. Death is the destiny of all the wicked, of all those who reject God. The needy will not always be neglected. The hope of the poor will not be crushed forever. Come, Lord, do not let men defy you. Bring the heathen before you and pronounce judgment on them. Make them afraid, O Lord. Make them know that they are only mortal beings. Psalms 10. A prayer for justice. Why are you so far away, O Lord? Why do you hide yourself when we are in trouble? The wicked are proud and persecute the poor. Catch them in the traps they have made. The wicked man is proud of his evil desires. The greedy man curses and rejects the Lord. A wicked man does not care about the Lord. In his pride, he thinks that God doesn't matter. A wicked man succeeds in everything. He cannot understand God's judgments. He sneers at his enemies. He says to himself, I will never fail. I will never be in trouble. His speech is filled with curses, lies, and threats. He is quick to speak hateful, evil words. He hides himself in the villages, waiting to murder innocent people. He spies on his helpless victims. He waits in his hiding place like a lion. He lies in it, waiting for the poor. He catches them in his trap and drags them away. The helpless victims lie crushed. Brute strength has defeated them. The wicked man says to himself, God doesn't care. He has closed his eyes and will never see me. O Lord, punish those wicked men. Remember those who are suffering. How can a wicked man despise God and say to himself, He will not punish me? But you do see, you take notice of trouble and suffering and are always ready to help. The helpless man commits himself to you. You have always helped the needy. Break the power of wicked and evil men. Punish them for the wrong they have done until they do it no more. The Lord is King forever and ever. Those who worship other gods will vanish from his land. You will listen, O Lord, to the prayers of the lowly. You will give them courage. You will hear the cries of the oppressed and the orphans. You will judge in their favor so that mortal men may cause terror no more. Psalms 11. Confidence in the Lord. I trust in the Lord for safety. How foolish of you to say to me, fly away like a bird to the mountains, because the wicked have drawn their bows and aim their arrows to shoot from the shadows at good men. There is nothing a good man can do when everything falls apart. The Lord is in his holy temple. He has his throne in heaven. He watches people everywhere and knows what they are doing. He examines the good and the wicked alike. The lawless he hates with all his heart. He sends down flaming coals and burning sulfur on the wicked. He punishes them with scorching winds. The Lord is righteous and loves good deeds. Those who do them will live in his presence. Psalms 12. A prayer for help. Help us, Lord. There is not a good man left. Honest man can no longer be found. All of them lie to one another. They deceive each other with flattery. Silence those flattering tongues. O Lord, close those boastful mouths that say, with our words we get what we want. We will say what we wish and no one can stop us. But now I will come, says the Lord, because the needy are oppressed and the persecuted groan in pain. I'll give them the security they long for. The promises of the Lord can be trusted. They're as genuine as silver, refined 7 times in the furnace. Wicked men are everywhere, and everyone praises what is evil. Keep us always safe, O Lord, and preserve us from such people. Psalms 13. A prayer for help. How much longer will you forget me, Lord? Forever? How much longer will you hide yourself from me? How long must I endure trouble? How long will sorrow fill my heart day and night? How long will my enemies trample me? Look at me, O Lord my God, and answer me. Restore my strength. Don't let me die. Don't let my enemies fail. We have defeated him. Don't let them gloat over my downfall. I rely on your constant love. I will be glad because you will rescue me. I'll sing to you, O Lord, because you have been good to me. Psalms 14. The wickedness of men. Fools say to themselves, there is no God. They are all corrupt, and they have done terrible things. There is no one who does what is right. The Lord looks down from heaven at mankind to see if there are any who are wise, any who worship him. But they have all gone wrong. They are all equally bad. Not one of them does what is right. Not a single one. Don't they know, asked the Lord. Are all these evildoers ignorant? They live by robbing my people, and they never pray to me. But then they will be terrified, for God is with those who obey him. Evildoers frustrate the plans of the humble man, but the Lord is his protection. How I pray the victory will come to Israel from Zion. How happy the people of Israel will be. The Lord makes them prosperous again. Psalms 15. What God requires. Lord, who may enter your temple? Who may worship on Zion, your sacred hill? A person who obeys God in everything and always does what is right, whose words are true and sincere, and who does not slander others. He does no wrong to his friends, nor spreads rumors about his neighbors. He despises those whom God rejects, but honors those who obey the Lord. He always does what he promises, no matter how much it may cost. He makes loans without charging interest and cannot be bribed to testify against the innocent. Whoever does these things will always be secure. Psalm 16. A prayer of confidence. Protect me, O God. I trust in you for safety. I say to the Lord, you are my Lord. All the good things I have come from you. How excellent are the Lord's faithful people. My greatest pleasure is to be with them. Those who rush to other gods bring many troubles on themselves. I will not take part in the sacrifices and not worship their gods. You, Lord, are all I have, and you give me all I need. My future is in your hands. How wonderful are your gifts to me. How good they are. I praise the Lord because he guides me. And in the night, my conscience warns me. I'm always aware of the Lord's presence. He is near and nothing can shake me. And so I'm thankful and glad, and I feel completely secure. Because you protect me from the power of death, I have served you faithfully. And you will not abandon me to the world of the dead. You will show me the path that leads to life. Your presence fills me with joy and brings me pleasure forever.
Psalm 17. The prayer of an innocent man. Listen, O Lord, to my plea for justice. Pay attention to my cry for help. Listen to my honest prayer. You will judge in my favor, because you know what is right. You know my heart. You have come to me at night. You examined me completely and found no evil desire in me. I speak no evil as others do.
I have obeyed your command and have not followed paths of violence. I have always walked in your way and have never strayed from it. I pray to you, O God, because you answer me. So turn to me and listen to my words. Reveal your wonderful love and save me. At your side, I am safe from my enemies. Protect me as you would your very eyes. Hide me in the shadow of your wings from the attack of the wicked. Deadly enemies surround me. They have no pity and speak proudly. They are around me now wherever I turn, watching for a chance to pull me down. They're like lions waiting for me, wanting to tear me to pieces. Come, Lord, oppose my enemies and defeat them. Save me from the wicked by your sword. Save me from those who in this life have all they want. Punish them with the sufferings you have stored up for them. May there be enough for the children and some left over for their children's children. But I will see you because I have done no wrong. And when I awake, your presence will fill me with joy. Psalms 18. David's Song of Victory. How I love you, Lord. You are my defender. The Lord is my protector. He is my strong fortress. My God is my protection, and with him I am safe. He protects me like a shield. He defends me and keeps me safe. I call to the Lord and he saves me from my enemies. Praise the Lord. The danger of death was all around me. The waves of destruction rolled over me. The danger of death was round me, and the grave set its trap for me. In my trouble, I called to the Lord. I called to my God for help. In his temple, he heard my voice. He listened to my cry for help. Then the earth trembled and shook. The foundations of the mountains rocked and quivered because God was angry. Smoke poured out of his nostrils, a consuming flame and burning coals from his mouth. He tore the sky apart and came down the dark cloud under his feet. He flew swiftly on a winged creature. He traveled on the wings of the wind. He covered himself with darkness. Thick clouds full of water surrounded him. Hailstones and flashes of fire came from the lightning before him and broke through the dark clouds. Then the Lord thundered from the sky, and the voice of the Most High was heard. He shot his arrows and scattered his enemies. With flashes of lightning, he sent them running. The floor of the ocean was laid bare, and the foundations of the earth were uncovered. When you rebuked your enemies, Lord, and roared at them in anger, the Lord reached down from above and took hold of me. He pulled me out of the deep waters. He rescued me from my powerful enemies and from all those who hate me. They were too strong for me when I was in trouble. They attacked me, but the Lord protected me. He helped me out of danger. He saved me because he was pleased with me. The Lord rewards me because I do what is right. He blesses me because I am innocent. I have obeyed the law of the Lord. I have not turned away from my God. I have observed all his laws. I have not disobeyed his commands. He knows that I am faultless, that I have kept myself from doing wrong. And so he rewards me because I do what is right, because he knows that I am innocent. O Lord, you are faithful to those who are faithful to you, completely good to those who are perfect. You are pure to those who are pure, but hostile to those who are wicked. You save those who are humble, but you humble those who are proud. O Lord, you give me light. You dispel my darkness. You gave me strength to attack my enemies and power to overcome the defenses. This God, how perfect are his deeds, how dependable his words. He is like a shield for all who seek his protection. The Lord alone is God. God alone is our defense. He is the God who makes me strong, who makes my pathway safe. He makes me sure-footed as a deer. He keeps me safe on the mountains. He trains me for battle so that I can use the strongest bow. Oh Lord, you protect me and save me. Your care has made me great and your power has kept me safe. You have kept me from being captured and I have never fallen. I pursue my enemies and catch them. I do not stop until I destroy them. I strike them down and they cannot rise. They lie defeated before me. You gave me strength for the battle and victory over my enemies. You make my enemies run from me. I destroy those who hate me. They cry for help, but no one saves them. They call to the Lord, but he does not answer. I crush them so that they become like dust, which the wind blows away. I trample on them like mud in the streets. You saved me from a rebellious people and made me ruler of the nations. People I did not know have now become my subjects. Foreigners bowed before me. When they hear me, they obey. They lose their courage and come trembling from their fortress. The Lord lives. Praise my defender. Proclaim the greatness of the God who saves me. He gives me victory over my enemies. He subdues the nations under me and saves me from my foes. Oh Lord, you give me victory over my enemies and protect me from violent men. And so I praise you among the nations. I sing praises to you. God gives great victories to his king. He shows constant love to the one he has chosen, to David and his descendants forever.
Psalms 19. God's glory in creation. How clearly the sky reveals God's glory. How plainly it shows what he has done. Each day announces it to the following day. Each night repeats it to the next. No speech or words are used. No sound is heard. Yet their message goes out to all the world and is heard to the ends of the earth. God made a home in the sky for the sun. It comes out in the morning like a happy bridegroom, like an athlete eager to run a race. It starts at one end of the sky and goes across to the other. Nothing can hide from its heat. The law of the Lord. The law of the Lord is perfect. It gives new strength. The commands of the Lord are trustworthy, giving wisdom to those who lack it. The laws of the Lord are right, and those who obey them are happy. The commands of the Lord are just and give understanding to the mind. Reverence for the Lord is good. It will continue forever. The judgments of the Lord are just. They are always fair. They are more desirable than the finest gold. They are sweeter than the purest honey. They give knowledge to me, your servant. I am rewarded for obeying them. No one can see his own errors. Deliver me, Lord, from hidden faults. Keep me safe, also from willful sins. Don't let them rule over me. Then I shall be perfect and free
from the evil of sin. May my words and my thoughts be acceptable to you, O Lord, my refuge and my redeemer.
Psalms 20, a prayer for victory. May the Lord answer you when you are in trouble. May the God of Jacob protect you. May he send you help from his temple and give you aid from Mount Zion. May he accept all your offerings and be pleased with all your sacrifice. May he give you what you desire and make all your plans succeed. Then we will shout for joy over your victory and celebrate your triumph by praising our God. May the Lord answer all your requests. Now I know that the Lord gives victory to his chosen king. He answers him from his holy heaven and by his power gives him great victories. Some trust in their war chariots and others in their horses, but we trust in the power of the Lord our God. Such people will stumble and fall, but we will rise and stand firm. Give victory to the King, O Lord. Answer us when we call.
Psalms 21, praise for victory. The King is glad, O Lord, because you gave him strength. He rejoices because you made him victorious. You have given him his heart's desire. You have answered his request. You come to him with great blessings and set a crown of gold on his head. He asked for life and you gave it, a long and lasting life. His glory is great because of your help. You have given him fame and majesty. Your blessings are with him forever, and your presence fills him with joy. The king trusts in the Lord Almighty, and because of the Lord's constant love, he will always be secure. The king will capture all his enemies. He'll capture everyone who hates him. He will destroy them like a blazing fire when he appears. The Lord will devour them in his anger, and fire will consume them. None of the descendants will survive. The king will kill them all. They make their plans and plot against him, but they will not succeed. He will shoot his arrow at them and make them turn and run. We praise you, Lord, for your great strength. We will sing and praise for your power.
Psalms 22, a cry of anguish and a song of praise. My God, my God, why have you abandoned me? I have cried desperately for help, but still it does not come. During the day I call to you, my God, but you do not answer. I call at night, but get no rest. But you are enthroned as the Holy One, the one whom Israel praises. Our ancestors put their trust in you. They trusted you and you saved them. They called to you and escaped from danger. They trusted you and were not disappointed. But I am no longer a man. I am a worm, despised and scorned by everyone. All who see me jeer at me. They stick out their tongues and shake their heads. You relied on the Lord, they say. Why doesn't he save you? If the Lord likes you, why doesn't he help you? It was you who brought me safely through birth. When I was a baby, you kept me safe. I have relied on you since the day I was born, and you have always been my God. Do not stay away from me. Trouble is near, and there is no one to help. Many enemies surround me like bulls. They're all around me, like fierce bulls from the land of Bashan. They open their mouths like lions roaring and tearing at me. My strength is gone like water split on the ground. All my bones are out of joint. My heart is like melted wax. My throat is as dry as dust, and my tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. You have left me dead for in the dust. A gang of evil men is round me. Like a pack of dogs, they close in on me. They tear at my hands and feet. All my bones can be seen. My enemies look at me and stare. They gamble for my clothes and divide them among themselves. Oh Lord, don't stay away from me. Come quickly to my rescue. Save me from my sword. Save my life from these dogs. Rescue me from these lions. I'm helpless before these wild bulls. I will tell my people what you have done. I praise you in the assembly. Praise him, you servants of the Lord. Honor him, you descendants of Jacob. Worship him, you people of Israel. He does not neglect the poor or ignore their suffering. He does not turn away from them, but answers when they call for help. In the full assembly, I will praise you for what you have done. In the presence of those who worship you, I will offer the sacrifices I promised. The poor will eat as much as they want. Those who come to the Lord will praise him. May they prosper forever. All nations will remember the Lord from every part of the world. They will turn to him. All races will worship him. The Lord is king and he rules the nations. All proud men will bow down to him. All mortal men will bow down before him. Future generations will serve him. Men will speak of the Lord to the coming generation. People not yet born will be told, the Lord saved his people.
Psalms 21. Praise for victory. The king is glad, O Lord, because you gave him strength. He rejoices because you made him victorious. You have given him his heart's desire. You have answered his request. You come to him with great blessings and set a crown of gold on his head. He asked for life and you gave it, a long and lasting life. His glory is great because of your help. You have given him fame and majesty. Your blessings are with him forever, and your presence fills him with joy. The king trusts in the Lord Almighty, and because of the Lord's constant love, he will always be secure. The king will capture all his enemies. He'll capture everyone who hates him. He will destroy them like a blazing fire when he appears. The Lord will devour them in his anger, and fire will consume them. None of the descendants will survive. The king will kill them all. They make their plans and plot against him, but they will not succeed. He will shoot his arrow at them and make them turn and run. We praise you, Lord, for your great strength. We will sing and praise for your power.
Psalms 22. A cry of anguish and a song of praise. My God, why have you abandoned me? I have cried desperately for help, but still it does not come. During the day I call to you, my God, but you do not answer. I call at night, but get no rest. But you are enthroned as the Holy One, the one whom Israel praises. Our ancestors put their trust in you. They trusted you and you saved them. They called to you and escaped from danger. They trusted you and were not disappointed. But I am no longer a man. I am a worm, despised and scorned by everyone. All who see me jeer at me. They stick out their tongues and shake their heads. You relied on the Lord, they say. Why doesn't he save you? If the Lord likes you, why doesn't he help you? It was you who brought me safely through birth. When I was a baby, you kept me safe. I have relied on you since the day I was born, and you always been my God. Do not stay away from me. Trouble is near and there is no one to help. Many enemies surround me like bulls. They're all round me like fierce bulls from the land of Bashan. They open their mouths like lions roaring and tearing at me. My strength is gone like water split on the ground. All my bones are out of joint. My heart is like melted wax.
My throat is as dry as dust, and my tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth. You have left me dead for in the dust. A gang of evil men is round me. Like a pack of dogs, they close in on me. They tear at my hands and feet. All my bones can be seen. My enemies look at me and stare. They gamble for my clothes and divide them among themselves. Oh Lord, don't stay away from me. Come quickly to my rescue. Save me from my sword. Save my life from these dogs. Rescue me from these lions. I'm helpless before these wild bulls. I will tell my people what you have done. I praise you in the assembly. Praise him, you servants of the Lord. Honor him, you descendants of Jacob. Worship him, you people of Israel. He does not neglect the poor or ignore their suffering. He does not turn away from them, but answers when they call for help. In the full assembly, I will praise you for what you have done. In the presence of those who worship you, I will offer the sacrifices I promised the poor eat as much as they want. Those who come to the Lord will praise him. May they prosper forever. All nations will remember the Lord from every part of the world. They will turn to him. All races will worship him. The Lord is king and he rules the nations. All proud men will bow down to him. All mortal men will bow down before him. Future generations will serve him. Men will speak of the Lord to the coming generation. People not yet born will be told, the Lord saved his people.
Psalms 23. The Lord our shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I have everything I need. He lets me rest in fields of green grass and leads me to quiet pools of fresh water. He gives me new strength. He guides me in the right path. As he had promised, even if I go to the deepest darkness, I will not be afraid, Lord, for you are with me. Your shepherd's rod and staff protect me. You prepare a banquet for me where all my enemies can see me. You welcome me as an honored guest and fill my cup to the brim. I know that your goodness and love will be with me all my life, and your house will be my home as long as I live.
Psalms 24. The Great King. The world and all that is in it belong to the Lord. The earth and all who live on it are his. He built it on the deep waters beneath the earth and laid its foundations in the ocean depths. Who has the right to go up the Lord's hill? Who may enter his holy temple? Those who are pure in his act and in thought, who do not worship idols or make false promises, the Lord will bless them and save them. God will declare them innocent. Such are the people who come to God, who come into the presence of the God of Jacob. Fling wide the gates, open the ancient doors, and the great king will come in. Who is this great king? He is the Lord, strong and mighty the Lord, victorious in battle.
Fling wide the gates, open the ancient doors, and the great king will come in. Who is this great king? The triumphant Lord. He is the great king.
Psalms 25, a prayer for guidance and protection. To you, O Lord, I offer my prayer. In you, my God, I trust. Save me from the shame of defeat. Don't let my enemies gloat over me. Defeat does not come to those who trust in you, but to those who are quick to rebel against you. Teach me your ways, O Lord. Make them known to me. Teach me to live according to your truth, for you are my God who saves me. I always trust in you. Remember, O Lord, your kindness and constant love, which you have shown from long ago. Forgive the sins and errors of my youth in your constant love and goodness. Remember me, Lord, because the Lord is righteous and good. He teaches the sinners the path they should follow. He leads the humble in the right way and teaches them his will. With faithfulness and love, he leads all who keep his command and obey his commands. Keep your promise, Lord, and forgive my sin, for they are many. Those who have reverence for the Lord will learn from him the path they should follow. They will always be prosperous, and the children will possess the land. Lord is a friend of those who obey him, and he affirms his covenant with them. I look to the Lord for help at all times, and rescues me from danger. Turn to me, Lord, and be merciful to me, because I am lonely and weak. Relieve me of my worries and save me from all my troubles. Consider my distress and suffering and forgive all my sins. See how many enemies I have. See how much they hate me. Protect me and save me. Keep me from defeat. I come to you for safety. May my goodness and honesty preserve me because I trust in you. From all their troubles, O God, save your people Israel.
Psalms 26, the prayer of a good man. Declare me innocent, O Lord, because I do what is right and trust you completely. Examine me and test me, Lord. Judge my desires and thoughts. Your constant love is my guide. Your faithfulness always leads me. I do not keep company with worthless people. I have nothing to do with hypocrites. I hate the company of evil men and avoid the wicked. Lord, I wash my hands to show that I am innocent and march in worship around your altar. I sing a hymn of thanksgiving and tell of all your wonderful deeds. I love the house where you live, O Lord, the place where your glory dwells. Do not destroy me with the sinners. Smear me from the fate of murderers, men who do evil all the time and are ready to take bribes. As for me, I do what is right. Be merciful to me and save me. I am safe from all distress.
Psalms.
In the assembly of his people,
Psalms.
I praise the Lord.